Hello everyone, this is Soren Kenson Laboratory Testing 1 and Lecture 21. Today we'll talk about the consolidation, especially the consolidation theory. And this consolidation theory is to estimate the time rate of the consolidation. So how fast the settlement will occur, that is the main purpose of that we are learning this consolidation theory. Let's recall the theory of the consolidation. For example, in a container, say that we have a clay specimen, and this can be the soil skeleton can be represented by this spring, and you have a loading plate, and if there's a additional stress increment by delta sigma, then as soon as you have a increment in the total stress, you have an excess pore pressure increase by delta sigma. Right? So the first instantaneously, because the water is much stiffer than the soil skeleton, so the water will take up all the load, and then it's gonna decrease with time, and this is the pressure curve, the curve of the excess pore pressure, right? And as the water escapes, this the excess pore pressure dissipation will be transferred to the vertical effective stress increase. So then you have another curve. If this is the total stress, we have another curve increase the vertical effective stress. So as delta UEX, the excess pore pressure, decreases, delta sigma prime, the effective stress, increases, and at the same time the clay is being consolidated. So it's called the time dependent settlement of the clay, because it takes time to occur and achieve the ultimate settlement, and that's controlled by the rate of the excess pore pressure dissipation. It means the excess pore pressure is dissipated. And we know how to calculate the ultimate consolidation settlement. The ultimate consolidated settlement SC can be calculated by the recompression index and original thickness and the initial voltage ratio and the initial vertical effective stress and the final vertical effective stress and the pre-consolidation stress, okay? And also the compression index. So from here, we can calculate the ultimate settlement that's going to occur. Well, this settlement will be achieved when delta UX goes to zero, so that the delta sigma prime becomes the same with the total stress increment. Right? But we have other question. Then how fast the settlement will occur? For example, we apply like 100 kilopascal to the ground surface, then like 1 month later, how much sediment will be occurred? Ultimately, we may know that the sediment will occur about like maybe 1 meter. Then how long it's gonna take until it settles down completely? So this rate of the sediment depends on the soil property, the compressibility, and permeability. And also it depends on the first and second initial distribution of excess pore pressure. And lastly, the drainage condition. Will affect to the weight of the sediment. So time rate of consolidation. Let's imagine that we have ground surface and there's a sand layer and clay layer and another sand layer. So when we apply the stress over a large area, the delta sigma, then here you have a excess pore pressure generated, for delta U will be the same as delta sigma, and that's gonna be that happens right after you apply the delta sigma. But as time goes by, this excess pore pressure will dissipate. So the water will be squeezed, but it's gonna escape to the sand layer, top and bottom, because the sand layer has a high permeability, a very high hydraulic conductivity, so it acts as a drainage layer. In this case, you have a drainage layer at the top and bottom, so the water can escape two-way, so it's called the two-way drainage condition. If we imagine the distribution of the excess pore pressure at the clay layer, at the time zero, you have an excess pore pressure generated by the amount of the total stress increment, the delta sigma. But as time goes by, at the top, because it's just nearby the drainage layer, you have zero excess pore pressure. So this is UEX. And also in here, you have zero excess pore pressure. So you have this kind of curve. And time goes by, it's gonna decrease and the water will escape. So the excess pore pressure will decrease this way. And effective stress, delta sigma prime, can be plotted in the same way, right? So at the time in zero, you have zero effective stress increment, but ultimately, you have this kind of effective stress distribution, the increase in effective stress over the clay layer at the time is infinite, and you have this kind of a time-varying effective stress distribution over the clay layer. So it increases. So then, question could be, what would be the excess pore pressure at midpoint of the clay at the center after 1 month or after 2 months? Can we predict that excess pore pressure? Because if we know the excess pore pressure, then we can calculate the effective stress, and from there we can estimate the sediment. So water near the drainage layer is case first, and excess pore pressure decreases, then effective stress increases at the local point. So the distribution of the excess pore pressure can be predicted by the Terzaghi's consolidation theory, which will be covered in class today. Let's look at the handout. So this handout covers the one-dimensional consolidation theory developed by Karl Terzaghi in 1925, and this is used to predict the time rate of the consolidation. So general equation for consolidation theory looks like this. So you have a first order of derivative excess pore pressure over the time, and Cv as a diffusion coefficient, what is called as the coefficient of the consolidation, and the second derivative of the excess pore pressure over Z, the spatial scale Z, where the coefficient of the consolidation Cv is defined as a function of permeability and voids ratio and the coefficient of compressibility AB. Or this term is also the same with the 1 over MV. This where the M is coefficient of the volume compressibility. So MV, according to definition, is equal to AV over 1 plus E naught. And the unit of the coefficient of the consolidation, the CV, is length square over time. So it's gonna be like meter square per second or meter square per minute or hour, something like that. The AV, the coefficient of compressibility, is defined as the negative slope of the E versus sigma V prime curve, and that's sigma V prime and E, and sorry. Please be careful with this, and this is the linear scale. So no logarithmic scale, and you have this kind of a curved shape, and then the slope, a negative slope, is called the AV minus dE over d sigma V prime. And the coefficient of the volume compressibility is the slope of the epsilon V, the volumetric strain, versus sigma V prime curve. So here, sigma V prime and the epsilon V. And because the epsilon V is the volumetric strain, is defined as minus delta E over 1 plus E naught, or minus dE over 1 plus E naught, right? So you have a curve increasing volumetric strain with the increase in vertical effective stress. So then the slope is defined as the coefficient of the volume compressibility. So d epsilon v over d sigma v prime. And here, remember that the epsilon, the positive epsilon, positive epsilon means the compression, so the volume contraction. And assumptions of this Terzaghi's one-dimensional consolidation theory are these. First one is the compressible solid layer is homogeneous, the same initial voids ratio and permeability at any location of that clay layer. So like in clay layer, over the thickness, you have a same voids ratio and the same permeability for that layer. And the soil is completely saturated with water, so it's a fully saturated condition. And soil grains and the water are incompressible. And Darcy's law is valid, so the Darcy's law is V is KI or Q is KIA that we learned from the previous chapters. Due to the large coverage area of the loading, one-dimensional drainage and compression are considered with no horizontal water flow and no lateral deformation. So this is the plain strain condition and zero lateral strain condition. And primary consolidation, the model does not account for the secondary compression. And small strain, it follows the small strain theory, which means that a stress increment applied produces only small strain there. So such as the AV and the K remain constant. With these assumptions, we can derive the consolidation equation, these two, Let's do it together. So, consider a small element of the soil, dx and dy and gg, with flow of water going in the z direction in a small time interval dt, between t and the t plus dt. So then, you have a q in and q out, and this is dz and dx, although, sorry, dy, and this is dx. You have a cube like this. And by continuity, the volume change in the soil element during consolidation is the same as the volume change in water at a given time dt. So here again, when there's a compression, water volume changes only because the solid will remain in the same. So delta V is total volume change is the same as the water volume change, and that's caused by the water flow rate, flux, the Q in and the Q out, or the dV is the same in with this equation. And let's recall the Darcy's law, which is a V, the velocity of the water flow is the same in the hydraulic conductivity times the hydraulic gradient. And here the I is the hydraulic head difference over the length. Here the H is total head. Then the volume of inflow, the Q in, is according to Darcy's law, K, I, and A, and dt. And I is hydraulic gradient, so round H over round Z. And area is this one, so the dx times dy here. So this is the area, and this is hydraulic gradient. And the volume of water leaving out of the element, Q out, is defined in the same way, but considering the hydraulic gradient changing as a function of Z, so that you have this as hydraulic gradient, but the area remains the same. So here the I is the same, I naught plus delta I. Then, thus, if we plug this equation 1 and equation 2 to the original equation, then Q out minus Q in can be simplified to this equation, equation 3. And this is not zero because it is transient flow. Our focus is on the excess pore pressure, so we need to replace the H in terms of the pore pressure. And you know that the total head, this is the total head, is sum of the elevation head plus the pressure head. And the pressure head is the pore pressure divided by the gamma W, or the rho dot times G. So if we do the partial difference, partially differentiate the equation 4. So the first derivative with respect to the z, and it becomes this one. And if we do the second derivative, if we get the second derivative, it becomes this equation. And then we call the continuity, the volume change in the soil element during the consolidation is the same as the volume change in the water at a given time t, dt. So change in water volume is the volume going in and minus volume going out minus the volume going in, water volume going in. So combining this equation 6 and 5, and also the 3 here, then you get this equation 7. So then now we have to convert this water volume change to voyage ratio change, and then we'll have to convert it to the vertical effective stress change. So let's relate this water volume change to the change in vertical effective stress. The voyage ratio is defined as the water volume over solid volume because it's a fully saturated condition. The water volume now is the multiplication of the voyage ratio times the solid volume, and if it is a partially differentiate this over this equation with respect to the dt, then it becomes this equation. So dvw is the same as dvs times round d over round t times dt. Then from the initial voyage ratio e naught, we can derive this vs following this procedure. So E naught is the water volume over solid volume, and the total volume of the soil is the solid volume plus water volume, so the 1 plus E naught times Vs. So the Vs is the can be expressed as a function of total volume and the initial void ratio, and here the total volume is dx times dz times dy. This is the element of the soil. Therefore, the equation 8, the volume change of water, can be expressed as follows, like the equation 8. Okay. From this equation. And combining this equation 8 with the equation 7, this one, and then we have this equation. So the voyage ratio change with time can be related to the excess pore pressure change, the second derivative of the excess pore pressure with respect to the z coordinate. Sorry, so this one. Then we get this equation. The voyage ratio change with time can be related to the excess pore pressure, second derivative excess pore pressure with respect to the spatial coordinate z. And there's this initial voyage ratio and the permeability and the water unit rate of the water as constant. So now we have to eliminate this E. So we have to convert it to the U, the excess pore pressure. So use the relation between E and sigma V prime by means of the AV, the compressibility term, and noting that AV is the coefficient of the compressibility. So total stress is the same with the effective stress plus U, the sigma prime plus U, when the total stress is constant. So in the clay layer, if there's a delta sigma applied, which is the total stress, and this delta sigma stays constant, right? Only the effective stress and the pore pressure inside changes. So then total stress change is the same with the effective stress change plus pore pressure change, but this is zero, so that there's a relation between the effective stress change and the pore pressure change. So if the pore pressure decreases with time, then it's going to cause the effective stress increase. So this equation makes sense. From the definition of the coefficient of the compressibility, the AB coefficient of the compressibility is defined as the negative slope of the E versus sigma V prime curve. So this is the definition. And then round D round T is a round D round sigma prime times sigma prime time over round T. So then this is the same as minus AV, so that now you convert the voids ratio to the pore pressure. Then it's all set. You can combine this equation 10 and 9, this one and the previous one, then you will have this final equation. Then finally, excess pore pressure, the rate of the excess pore pressure change is expressed as a function of CV and the second derivative of the excess pore pressure. Here the CV is defined as this one. And this is a material property. Okay, in the next class, we'll see how we can solve this Terry-Jacques one-dimensional consolidation theory, right, using the graphical solution and numerical solution. Thank you.